Hey everybody, Andy here. So did you know that your internet service provider or ISP is legally allowed to collect and sell data they collect about you to anyone? That means everything from the sites you visit, things you search for, emails you send and read, everything can be collected and sold to other companies. And all of this is legal. Now, there are a few things you can do to protect yourself from being spied on. And as you know, on our channel, we like to share with you all there is to know about internet security. So in today's video, we're going to talk about what ISPs are allowed to do and three ways you can hide your internet activity. And as always, we'll include any helpful links in the description below, so be sure to check those out as well. Now, there are three things your ISP is allowed to do. The first I mentioned in the intro, sell your information to third parties. And I've never known anyone to say, gee, I just love being spied on. But that being said, you might be thinking, well, Andy, why should I care if my ISP is collecting data from me? Maybe you like the targeted ads on your device, and some people do. But the thing is, unless you're covering your tracks while you're online, there's nothing you can do to stop your ISP from collecting data on you. And as for the reasons why you should care, well, there are a number of reasons why people do. First, data breaches happen all the time, and ISPs aren't immune to those. And secondly, it matters more to some people than others. The second thing your ISP is allowed to do is keep the data they collect on you for up to 2 years. And third, they can even share the content of your browsing history with the government. So in some situations, people really have to consider what they've been viewing online and whether they want anyone else to know about it or not. Now, that being said, the main reason for hiding your internet activity from your ISP can be summed up in three things: security, privacy, and anonymity. And there are three effective ways you can do that. The best option being get a VPN. Now, VPNs work by connecting you to a proxy server and encrypting your data so that no one can read it. And there are many free and paid VPNs to choose from, so, well, where do you start? Well, we talk a lot about VPNs on this channel, so you'll probably hear this a lot, but we recommend being cautious about free VPNs. Usually, we don't recommend them at all, because they often come with malware and sell your information to third parties as well. And if you don't want your ISP selling your information, why would you want your VPN doing it, right? So it's usually better to avoid the free VPNs and look for a top quality paid version, which are only a few dollars a month and will give you better security overall. Plus, you can be sure that they don't come with the malware or sell your information. And we'll go ahead and put some recommendations in the description below if you'd like to take a look at that. But that being said, if you decide to look around for VPNs on your own, make sure you read the privacy policy. I know a lot of people don't do this, but you got to read it very carefully to make sure that you know what you're agreeing to before you accept it. But if that whole process of reviewing a bunch of VPNs and reading privacy policies sound a bit overwhelming and you just want some direction, I do have a video on my top recommendations for cybersecurity products, and I include my top VPN pick on the video, so I'll link to that in the description, and feel free to click on it anytime and check it out. Now, sometimes using a VPN works well with our second option to hide your internet activity called Tor. Now, Tor is basically a tool that provides anonymity by using a series of computers which are distributed across the world to hide your IP address and make your network trail difficult to trace. But it can make your connection very slow, though it's completely free and trustworthy. And it adds layers of encryption by making internet traffic leave your device and take a random route. Now, there are some advantages to using Tor, like the fact that it's free, well, for one. But there are some disadvantages too, like the fact that it's slow and it could attract the attention of law enforcement. And since it only keeps browsing secure, if you decide to use Tor, it's best to combine it with a VPN. And for Tor, we recommend NordVPN because it has a feature called Tor over VPN, so they complement each other very well. That's just something to keep in mind if you decide to use Tor. And finally, you can also use an extension called HTTPS Everywhere. It's free and easy to use. However, it doesn't work all the time, and it only encrypts browsing activity. So basically, this extension allows you to visit the encrypted HTTPS versions of websites rather than the unencrypted HTTP. And by using HTTPS Everywhere, you'll be able to encrypt the content of the websites you visit. But if the websites don't support HTTPS, they may not work, or the site won't be encrypted. So that being said, if you choose this option, it would probably be best to do this combined with using a VPN. Well, and that brings me to my final thoughts. Now, out of the three ways you can hide your browsing activity, the most secure and private way is by using a VPN. Plus, VPNs have the added benefit of securing other apps and activities aside from browsing. And using Tor and HTTPS Everywhere are also good options, but it's a great idea to combine those with a VPN if you decide to do those, because both only work with browsing and neither give you the same security as a VPN. So, thanks for watching. I hope this video has been helpful. And if you have any questions about cybersecurity or VPNs, we're always happy to help with those. Also, if there's any other video topics we should address, please let us know in the comments about that as well. Otherwise, thanks so much for watching. Welcome to the community. Thanks for being one of our cyber friends, and I'll see you in the next video.